Okay, so Mosaic has released their 30 billion parameter model. So in the past, I've covered the MPT-7B, and I'm kind of surprised that the 30 was the next up. I remember vaguely seeing some screenshots that they were training a 13.1.3.3.0 as well, but that doesn't seem to have come out. So the next one out seems to be the 30B. From everything that we can see, it looks like it's a really good model. It's got a number of interesting things. Probably the biggest interesting factor in here is that it's got an 8K context window. So that means that we really can go out to longer sequences and both generate longer sequences, but also have longer inputs to this. So meaning that you'll be able to do summarization of much longer text than we've been able to do before, that kind of thing. Obviously, not as much as the new 16K window from ChatGPT or even the story writer window of 65K that the MPT-7 had in the past. But 8K is still very useful, and it really sets this model a little bit more apart from the other Open Llama models and some of the other Llama models that have come along recently. So we can see that, okay, they're basically talking about running this, and it does look like they've talked about that, you know, that people have converted the 7B to a few different kinds of formats. The 7B models have been downloaded over 3 million times, which is pretty amazing to think about, that they've been used that many times already, and probably used a lot more than that, just that many downloads already. So here we can see that they've released three new models for this. So we've got the base model, the MPT-30B, we've got the instruct model, and we've got a chat model. So each of these is slightly different. Obviously, the base one is what we would use for basically fine-tuning new models on this. And you're going to need a decent amount of GPUs to be able to fine tune this model overall. So another thing that they point out is that this is one of the first models, necessarily that it is the first, to basically use H100s for training, but it's certainly one of the first ones to do that. And they also talk about that one of the things that they've done with this is they've trained it using Alibi. So you can actually extend out beyond the 8K token limit. So if you wanted to go to something longer, now, they don't make any claims about the performance of how far you can go out. I think you can probably go out to 16K with, I guess, decent performance. Again, most of that won't be for generation. It would be for taking in a long context window and then generating a few thousand tokens out on the end of that. So they do mention that, you know, this model was made so that you could fit this on an A100 80 gigabyte GPU in 16-bit. I'm actually going to run it on two A100 40 gigs in 16-bit, although you can run it also just on one A100 40 gigabyte if you go down to 8-bit precision for this. Obviously, the challenge when you go down to 8-bit precision, or one of the challenges, is that it just gets a lot slower to generate out. So that's something that you need to take into account as well. So Mosaic themselves are setting themselves up as a startup to basically do training for people and do inference for people. So they talk a little bit about, you know, the services they're offering here with training, with different kinds of inference, that kind of thing. So if we look at the actual models and their training data, we can see it's a pretty similar split. Pretty sure this is a pretty similar split to the 7-1, although people are now starting to make use of the Red Pajama data set a lot more. And because they did quite a lot of the training with a 4K token window, and then just fine tune for the 8K token window, we can see that, okay, what did they actually focus the fine tuning on? So that's kind of interesting to see as well. I don't know how much that will actually affect the output. That's something that's interesting to know, that if they had gone for doing more of that fine tuning at the end for the 8K on code or something, does that, you know, radically affect the model here? They've got a nice diagram of just showing what the sort of tasks that their, you know, that their data set is going for, which I think is pretty interesting to look at, compare the sort of the Falcon, the Llama to these, just to see, okay, you know, how do these actually compare for this? It's also interesting to see them compare these models against each other. So we can see that the chat model, when measured at 1,000 token sequences, seems to be doing better for this sort of coding than some of the other models. And yeah, all three of these are doing, you know, obviously much better than the Replit 3 billion model, which we'd expect just because of size. Interesting to compare it to the StarCoder models, which are, you know, quite a bit smaller than these as well. But you know, this model wasn't trained purely to be focused on code-related tasks. Yeah. So if you want to just try the model out yourself or one of the models, they've actually put up the 30 billion chat model as a Hugging Face space. From having a look at the back-end code of this, it seems like they're actually just pinging their own APIs where they're actually serving this model and then streaming it in. The inference times here are nice and snappy. So in a second, I'll go through and walk through the actual Instruct model, which they don't have up on Hugging Face. One of the interesting things about this is that this model seems a bit more reluctant to basically answer questions. Yet you'll see with the Instructor model, when you ask it personal questions, it tends to respond quite easily for this. So if you're interested, come in and have a play with it here. And then if you really want to, you can basically spin up the code and try it out yourself. So let's jump into the notebook and have a look at running the MPT-30B Instruct model. Okay, so this is a bit of a beast of a model to get running in a notebook here. I've gone through and you probably won't be able to run this in a normal Colab. I'm actually running two A100s here at the start. That's not something you can do with Colab Pro or Pro Plus or anything like that. I will say though, if you want to run the 8-bit version of this, that will run on one A100. So I've put in code so that you could do that and you can uncomment that and run that as well. So here I'm basically just bringing in the model. Like I said, if you want to load it in 8-bit, you can try loading it in 8-bit here, and that should work with a single A100. To load it in 16-bit like this, you need to actually have two A100s running for the 40 gigabyte ones. But if I had an 80 gigabyte, then I think it should fit in that. So there are a couple of ways to run this. So this is like just the simplest way I've done here, but you can also run it with the flash attention here. So you just need to make sure that you've got Triton installed and then run this through. I definitely found this one running quicker. I played around with a few different versions of this, and the 8-bit ones I find very slow for this. So you can see that when I'm running it in just plain 16-bit beef floats here, we're using around about 58 gigabytes of VRAM there from the two A100s combined there. All right, so you will need to basically set it up with a prompt. So the prompt in here is the prompt that they've given. If we look at the output of this model, it is very impressive, right? It really is very impressive. Not only do we get, you know, very good factual sort of information or to standard questions that we've had before, like what's the difference between alpacas and llamas, those sorts of things, but we actually get really nice quality emails being written out of this. So this is one of the things that I thought was quite nice. Having generated a few of these and looking through them, I found that the emails that it generated out were pretty good quality for this. It also seems to have, it doesn't seem to have the whole as an AI language model XYZ, which is good, I guess, but it does have some funny quirks where here I ask it, you know, as an AI, do you like The Simpsons? What do you know about Homer? So it doesn't say that it can't tell me an answer, but it gives me this sort of strange answer of, I've processed many episodes of The Simpsons. I have 98.3 confidence. So it seems like it thinks this is how an AI should respond to this. So just asking that question a few different ways, we get some different answers out. And it's interesting to see, okay, what are the answers out that we get from this? Playing around with the model, it does seem, you know, quite malleable to be giving it some sort of personality directions, those sorts of things, which is good to see. I was pleased to see that for some of the logic stuff, so this is from the FLAN T5 papers, it is able to get that correct. But then when we look at the haiku question, it doesn't seem to do as good job on this one, at getting this one correct here. It could be that if we run these a few times, sometimes we're going to get positive answers, sometimes we're going to get negative from this. Just some of the other standard questions I've put up there. Another one that I thought was interesting is it does a good job at things like this, like converting the following to JSON. It seemed to know this. Looking at the various models, the chat model probably should be better at code stuff than this model based on the fine tunings. Again, here you can see when we ask it, how are you today? It gives us an answer. It doesn't give us the as an AI language model stuff, which is nice to see for this. And I think one of the things that they talked about is that they're planning to release a new version of the Instruct 7B as well, which could be really interesting if it's trained in the same way for using that going forward. Here we can see that, okay, you know, it does quite nicely at giving us a plan. Everything's on track with this. And even things like a summarization. So here I've basically asked it to do a summarization. I wouldn't say it's done a fantastic summarization. It's still quite long. Maybe, you know, we could play around asking it to please summarize this to 2 paragraphs or something like that and see what you would get out. Asking it to do it as bullet points, it does a nice job there as well. So this does show me that these models and this series of 30B models from Mosaic really do have a lot more of the qualities that we've seen in some of the OpenAI models and some of the much bigger models, which is great to see. It's got to leave us wondering, are they working on a 65 billion version of this? Because that is probably going to be a pretty amazing model if they can get the quality to keep increasing like it has for this one. Anyway, as I mentioned, I'll put this in for people to be able to play with. This will only work if, you know, in 16-bit, if you have multiple GPUs. You're probably going to need a number of them if you're using home 3090s or something. I think you're going to need probably at least 3 or 4 to get this working. Running it in 8-bit, though, you can get it going pretty slowly, I think, on 2 3090s on a single A100 for this. This is Sam in the future. I just wanted to point out, after playing with this for a little bit, I managed to increase the speed of it quite a lot. So playing around, I don't seem to be getting the Triton to work properly, although it's extremely fast. It's not producing great quality output for some reason. I need to look into that. But by loading it like this in 16-bit and by fixing up the tokenizers here, it's massively sped up the whole thing. So this is basically now getting much quicker speeds for the generation for this. So you can see this is like 500 milliseconds for the, what is the capital of England. You'll see that even this one, I think, was taking like 2 minutes or more before. It's down to like 36 seconds now, much faster overall. This is like 8 seconds. So we're getting much faster outputs from this. So I just thought I'd just quickly show this. This is the notebook that I'll end up sharing. Check it out. Have a play with it yourself. Don't forget that if you want to run it exactly like this, you're going to need multiple GPUs to be able to run it. Don't forget, you can always actually just play with the chat model on the Hugging Face Hub at the moment. And if people are really interested, we could look at doing maybe a 4-bit version of this to run easier and quicker for people. Anyway, as always, if you've got questions, please put them in the comments below. If you like the video, please click like and subscribe. I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.